Welcome back to Java Tutorials for Beginners. In this tutorial, we are going to learn more about interface in Java with examples of Java program. Interface is the process of object-oriented programming principles like polymorphism and inheritance using abstraction. Let's see more about interface in Java. Do you know interface is similar to a class? We can say it is a complete abstract class which contains mostly set of methods without any body. And it can be called the blueprint for a class. Any public class which is implementing an interface must provide implementations of all the declared methods. Interfaces uses key concepts of object-oriented programming of Java like abstraction, inheritance, and polymorphism. We can create reusable and flexible software components with the help of interfaces. Like abstract classes, the objects of interfaces cannot be created, but we can implement an interface. Java 8 onwards, interfaces could also have concrete methods. These methods will be the type of static or default, but mostly public abstract methods are defined in the interface. Here, let's see importance of Java interfaces. As we have discussed, interface methods are group of methods without any body. Interface defines set of specifications that classes need to implement. In case of abstract class, it can implement only a selected few methods when implementing an interface. All the methods in an interface are implicitly public and all fields or variables are public static final. That means even if you are not declaring methods and fields explicitly inside an interface, it will be defined automatically in this way. The class which uses these interfaces are using implements keyword. Let's move on to the advantages of using Java interfaces. The main advantage of interfaces is to achieve complete abstraction. Since extending of two classes into another class is not supported for multiple inheritance, this can be achieved by the use of interfaces. For the classes which are implementing interfaces are loosely coupled, or in other words, we can say mostly these are independent. In this example, we can see how class is implementing an interface. There is an interface called shape defined with a calculate area method in it without any body. And there is another class named rectangle which implements the shape interface. So the method calculate area implementation should be there inside the class. Let's run the output of the program and see the result. The area of a rectangle is 50. Do you know that Java does not allow multiple inheritance with the classes to avoid ambiguity? If you want to know more about inheritance in Java, please watch out our previous Java inheritance tutorial. The problem exists if two classes have the same method which need to be extended to another class and it causes ambiguity. But we can implement more than one interfaces in class to avoid ambiguity. We can explain this using an example. First, let us see an example which is giving an error while trying to extend two classes into a single class. In this example, we can see there are two classes, class A and class B, defined with same method named move in it. When we try to extend these two classes into a single class, Java shows an error for it. So for to avoid this error, we can try to implement this using class extends a class and implementing another interface. Class extends class and implementing interface. In this, we can see an example. There is an interface named position. In this interface, we can see a method named move. And there is another class car. In this, we can see there are two methods, start and stop. Another class named Tesla. In this, it extends the car class and it's implementing the position interface. Here, we are implementing the method move from position interface. Do you know what is tag interface? Tag interface is used to provide essential information to JVM to perform an operation. Serializable remote event listeners are few of the examples of tag interfaces. These interfaces does not have any body, but these interfaces are meaningful to the JVM. Example for marking it as serializable. Let's discuss about nested interfaces in Java. We can declare interfaces as separate interface or as part of another interface. These interfaces are called as nested interface or member interface. We need to make sure that the interface declared inside a class should not be private. And when we declare interfaces outside of any class, it should have public and default access specifiers. Example, there are two interfaces defined, one inside another with method named show. In nested testing class, we can see which implements interfaces need show method implementation. Let us now run the program and see the output. Thank you for watching our video. Please stay tuned for upcoming Java tutorials.